Now I am continuing with my next presentation, that is the female reproductive system of Fasciola hepatica. The female reproductive system of Fasciola hepatica consists of ovary, oviduct, uterus, betuline glands, Mehle's glands and lower canal. Ovary is single tube-like structure and branched. They are situated in the anterior of the testis and right side in the anterior one-third of the body. Second is the oviduct. All the branches of ovary, they are open into a short and narrow tube called oviduct. And the oviduct, they travels down obliquely and open into the median vitelline duct. Next is the uterus. Uterus is the junction of the oviduct and median vitelline duct that arise from the convoluted uterus having fertilized cell tanks or capsules. The uterus open by a female genital aperture into the common genital atrium on the left side of the male genital aperture. The uterus is comparatively small and it lies in front of the gonads. The terminal part of the uterus has muscular walls referred to as macrotomes, which eject the egg and also sometimes receives the serous during the copulation. Here you see the structure. I have already tell you in the previous video, the Fasciola hepatica is hermaphrodite, bisexual. Both the sexes are present in the same organism. Here, this is the ovary. I have tell you ovary. Ovary is the single branch-like tubular that go to into the oviduct. This is the oviduct. And here, after oviduct, that is uterus, and in the uterus eggs, in the ovary eggs comes, and here the fertilization occur in the oviduct, and then after the fertilization, the capsules, the fertilized egg enter into the uterus, and here is the three transverse vitelline duct that is widened in the yolk reservoir. And here is the Mehle's glands. The Mehle's gland secrete the substance which harden the egg, which harden the eggs. And here this yolk reservoir provide nourishment to the fertilized egg. After the fertilization, their egg release into the uterus, and the here is the female genital pore. And in the male reproductive system and female, both they are open into the genital atrium, is the common opening of the male and female genital pore. Here you see the structure, that is the yolk reservoir. This is the transverse vitelline duct. Here this is the ovary. In the, what is the function of the ovary? Ovary release the egg and that comes into the oviduct. And here, this is the Mehle's glands, they secrete the chemical which make harden the egg. This is the lower canals. What is the function of the lower canals? Lower canal, this is the vestigial vagina which help in passage of sperm into the oviduct. During the copulation, the serous enter into it and the sperms are released through the lower canals. Here I have already told you the vitelline glands. Vitelline glands, they open into minute duct, longitudinal vitelline duct. Vitelline glands, they open into vitelline duct on each sides, and the two longitudinal duct are connected together by a transverse vitelline duct placed above the middle of the body. The transverse vitelline duct, I have already tell you, they swollen in the center to form yolk reservoir. From the yolk reservoir, a median vitelline duct start and run forward to join with the oviduct. And this is the Mehle's glands. Mehle's gland, I have already tell you, this lubricate the passage of egg in the uterus and they harden the egg cells. Or the function of the Mehle's gland, they release the secrete the lubricates and help in the activation of the spermatozoa. Next is the Laurel canal. This is the vestigial, act as a vestigial vagina during the copulation. So this is about the female reproductive system. Thank you. Thank you very much.